Did you know that you can reduce your expenses by billing the clients for the expenses that you pay? This video will show you how to record that. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. For our last example regarding billable expenses to clients, we will learn how to reduce our expenses at the moment we bill the client. In other words, billable expenses do not have to be included as income. You can instead make the original expense decrease. The idea is that if you billed the client for the expense and added it to their balance, then you no longer have that expense. But in order to do this, we must first set this up in the account settings window. In the top right of the screen, click the cog wheel, then go all the way across to the Your Company column, and the top choice is Account and Settings. Double click. The category of settings that we are changing is the Expense tab in the left panel. So click on the Expense tab, and we're changing something in the top section here. That means we have to click the pencil icon. Now, we had changed this before. Originally, when we started the billable section of this course, we came to the window and we clicked this check mark to be able to track billable expenses as income. However, now we are not going to track billable expenses as income. Instead, we will treat them as a reduction of the original expense that we paid. So if we click the check mark, that would solve the problem. However, there's an important point that you must understand. Please note, if you are changing back to reducing expenses rather than acknowledging income for billables, you must make sure to remove any default markup. Because if you forget, QuickBooks Online will still mark up the billable expenses and include that markup as markup income, the kind that we learned about in the previous video. So don't forget to change this back to zero and remove this check mark as well, only in the rare case that you're switching back from tracking billable expenses as income, changing it to the way we're doing now, simply remove the expense instead of charging, instead of acknowledging income. Click Save, and now we click Done in the Account Settings window. And now let's take a look at the example. This is our fourth and final example regarding billable expenses for contractors. On March 30th, we paid FedEx $900 for a delivery related to the Southwoods Road job. Well, that's very simple. And we will click New, Expense, because there was no check number. And we know that the vendor was FedEx, and it was $900 on March 30th. FedEx, March 30th, and it was delivery expense, and it is billable in the amount of $900. And it's billable specifically for the Southwoods Road job under Kirschbaum. Now, when we click Save and Close, we can click Reports, Custom Reports, Profit and Loss by Customer. Now let's go across to the Southwoods Road job, and you can see Southwoods Road for delivery expense now has a total of $1,200. But if we double click, you see that $900 out of that $1,200 is to FedEx, and that's the one that we just recorded. So we now have $900 because of this March 30th. We now have $900 more Out of the total 1,200, here let's click the back arrow. Out of the total 1,200 of delivery expense, 1,200 to the Southwoods Road job. It's hard to fit it into the whole screen. 1,200, 900 of that was just added now as an expense. That means when we bill Kirschbaum for that 900, that means that this 1,200 will be reduced by 900, and that 900 will not show up here as income. It will simply reduce the amount of delivery expense for the Kirschbaum job. So what's next? April 3rd, we made another invoice for 20% more of the work done on the Southwoods Road job. And on that invoice, we will add the March 30th expense that we paid for delivery. So, very simple. We all know we click New, and we go to Invoice, and we know the date of the invoice is April 3rd, and we know it's for the Kirschbaum Southwoods Road job. We remember that first you have to add from the estimate before you add the billable expenses. So we click Add from the Estimate, and hopefully QuickBooks Online will remember that we're billing for 20% of each line. And that we click Copy to Invoice, and just like all the other videos, 20% of each item from the estimate shows up here, or the 20% of the money amount and quantity and so forth show up here, because we finished another 20% of the job. Now on the billable expense, we click Add, and you can see 900 shows up at the bottom of this invoice. And again, I always recommend that you put this for yourself, because once you save the invoice, you will not know the reason for the billable expense unless you write the description. Now, watch what happens in the customer profit and loss when we click Save and Close. We now click, we're already here. Now when we come back to the profit and loss by customer, here's delivery expense, and go across to the Southwoods Road building. Aha! It now has decreased back down to 300. And you don't see anything up here in income for delivery. And if I click the delivery expense for 300, you can see it was 300. Then we paid FedEx 900. Then you can see the line of the minus 900 shows that when we put it on the invoice for Kirschbaum and the Southwoods Road, QuickBooks lowered our delivery expense by 900. Because we are no longer responsible for that 900 once we put it on the customer's invoice and add it to the customer's balance.